So how would we go about designing one of these active low-pass filters using a Sallen Key circuit? It turns out that the design procedure is rather simple compared to the equivalent design procedure that we would use for a passive low-pass filter, for instance. In order to design an active low-pass filter, or any low-pass filter really, we only need to specify two things. We need to specify the order of the filter in and the cutoff frequency f sub b. After applying the design procedure, we should obtain the values of the circuit components inside the Sallen Key circuit, R, C, and the feedback resistor, R sub F. The Sallen Key circuit displayed right now is a second order low pass filter. It has two capacitors, so we know it has two poles. To obtain an nth order filter, N over two circuits can be cascaded. And we have to assume that N is an even number because each Sallen Key circuit has two capacitors in it. The 3 dB cutoff frequency of the overall filter is related to resistor R and capacitor C by the equation that you're seeing. Usually, we want to design for a given cutoff frequency, so the best design procedure is to choose the capacitor value first and then calculate R using the equation. Now, typically, if the capacitor selected is too small, then the resistance can be unrealistically large, or the capacitor that you choose might start to become too similar to stray or parasitic capacitances in the circuit. So, generally, the rule that you want to apply, given the design freedom that you have in this equation, is to choose a small capacitor, but not so small that you approach parasitic capacitance values. For example, if you're going to build a circuit on a breadboard, then typical plate-to-plate capacitances on a breadboard would be on the order of 50 to 100 picofarads. So you wouldn't want your filter's capacitors to be that low. So you should choose reasonably large capacitors, but not so large that the resistors then are too small. Notice that in the circuit, the op amp and the feedback resistors R sub F and the K minus 1 R sub F resistor form a non-inverting amplifier with a gain of K. In fact, that's why I labeled that second resistor K minus 1 times R sub F, so that the gain K would be obvious. At DC, these capacitors act as open circuits. Then the resistors labeled R are just in series with the input terminals of the non-inverting amplifier, and they don't affect the gain at all. Therefore, the DC gain of the circuit is just K. As K is varied from 0 to 3, the transfer function would display more and more peaking, that is, the gain magnitude would increase with the frequency. And it turns out that if K were to hypothetically equal 3, then the gain peak goes to infinity, it means that the circuit wouldn't be stable anymore. So when we design these filters, we always need to keep the magnitude of the DC gain K less than 3. To minimize the effects of the bias current, it's recommended to choose values such that the parallel combination of the two feedback resistors is equal to 2R. But in fact, with modern op amps, the bias current plays such a little role that it really doesn't matter to do this. The table that you're seeing right now allows you to choose the appropriate gain magnitude. For example, with a second order filter, you have to choose a K of 1.586, and that ensures that the filter will be a Butterworth filter. If you want an order of 4, then you have to have two stages, one cascaded after another, each of them with a slightly different DC magnitude, and that would ensure that your fourth order filter would be a Butterworth filter. So in summary, in order to design an active low-pass Butterworth filter, we need to specify the order of the filter in, the cutoff frequency F sub B. We can then use the equation shown, choose a capacitor, and then find R from it. We can then determine K based on the order of the filter, and then it turns out that we can choose any reasonable feedback resistor. That completes the filter design process. In the next video, we'll do an example and actually design one of these low-pass filters.